It's a floorball night in Texas. Good evening, everybody. We're coming to you live from the Texas Christian University Recreation Center here in Fort Worth, Texas on YouTube IFF Channel 1. Welcome to tonight's game here. It's the World Floorball Championships North American Qualifiers. Game one of a two-game series between Team USA and Team Canada. My name is Drew Pelto. I'll be bringing you all the action here tonight. Joined here up in the booth by Theo Blanco. Theo, what a big event this has to be for USA Floorball. I mean, just for the sport as a whole here in North America.
Absolutely. It's a fantastic place, arena. It's a great matchup, and looking forward to a hard-nosed, very, very physical game.
Several of these players you're a bit familiar with as the coach of the under-19 team for USA. Several very young players here on this American roster.
That's correct. We have four people that are the U19 players that are taking the bump up and are going to play with the men's team, and hopefully they can contribute as much as possible.
Average age for this Team USA, only 22 years, so a lot of very young players. I mean, you look out there, you've got like Alex Radical, defenseman, only 16 years of age, playing up here at this level. So really, really exciting to see kind of the future of USA floorball right here.
Yeah, it is very exciting. It's super to have Alex take the step up, and he's proved himself, and he deserves to be and give it a shot here with the guys. Had a great game with the against the North Texas Floorball Association yesterday as a practice game, and he did really well. So, yeah, he deserves a spot on the team.
Speaking of that, a North Texas Floorball Association squad, three members of it playing here for Team USA. Definitely kind of turned into a little bit of almost an American floorball mecca here in North Texas here. A lot of growth here in the sport around the Dallas and Fort Worth area. I know I got into it around 2013 or thereabouts when I first moved down here, and it has just kept on growing ever since. So definitely good to see that.
Yeah, absolutely. Texas has been a forefront for floorball with the Dallas-Fort Worth area. They're even growing it more and more. The Austin area as well in Texas has been a big club down there that's been around for about 15 years. So it's great to see that floorball is growing.
Probably hear some cheering in the background there as the teams make their way out onto the floor. We'll give you a quick rundown here of the rosters for the two teams. For Team USA, it's going to be, as you mentioned, Alex Radical, the youngest player out there on the floor. He'll be in the number four jersey. Jonathan Muller, number five for Team USA. Maximus Blanco, number eight. Isaac Angerstig, number 10. Dario Fusi, number 13. David Hansen in the number 16 jersey. We'll have Alexander McVeigh in the number 20 uniform. Joachim Soderbaum in the 22 jersey. Liam Williamson in 23 jersey, Keen Addington wearing 37, Case Connor wearing 64, Adam Strobeck number 71, Miko Vahavahe number 79, Colin Kenai Abersol number 86, and Derek Moser number 93. In goal for Team USA, it is going to be Sebastian Stockley and Trent Plake. Right now, we'll turn things over to our PA announcer for the announcement of the starting lineups.
Through the night.
Down of the Canadian roster as well. Number 5 is Stephen Friedley. Number 7, Cedric Grenepin. Number 8, James Daly. Number 9, Cameron Buck. Number 10 is Justin Lacaire. Number 15 is Taylor Walsh. Number 51, Francis Laverne. Number 50, Alex Jetty. Number 55, Tristan Walsh. Number 61 is Matthew Smith. Number 67 is Etu Lumiela. Number 77 is Lowry Berg. Number 81, Bill Petrie. Number 82, Jonathan Kaisten. Number 86 is Michael Hudson. And it's now we will get the starters announced for both teams.
77. Nico. 71. Adam Sherman.
Starting lineups for both of these teams.
Team
Canada, three Ottawa players on their forwards and centers there, though. So a little bit of a team connection right there between those guys. I mentioned there with Team USA, three guys from the North Texas Floorball Association there. Over the other end, seven players, I believe, were rostered for from Ottawa here for this Canada team.
Exactly, and that gives them a very strong advantage when they're talking about knowing where they're going to be out on the court, and you got the USA team, a little younger team, and a lot of guys thrown together. Both Chicago and the NTFA have a couple, three players on each team. That's good, but it definitely is an advantage when you have six, seven guys on your roster that are from the same team and played together quite a bit.
Those three Chicago players mentioned all playing on the third line for Team USA here with Case Connor, Derek Moser, and Keen Addington all together. As we get the centers out to center court right here, it's going to be Grenepin and Hansen on your opening faceoff. Team USA in the blue uniforms, they're going to be going right to left across your TV screen as we are underway here in Fort Worth, Texas. USA controls the draw, played off the near side boards, and finally forced back on the defense for Canada here. It's going to be sent back over to the near side for Kaisten. Kaisten looking ahead, he'll drop back for Laverne as Laverne comes near side. Up the boards, tapped down into the USA end. Now finally back the other way, USA comes. Broken away again, as now will be Grenepin to pick up for Canada. Far side, Grenepin puts the brakes on, tapping it back to Matthew Smith. Smith back for Laverne, the defenseman here, as he will now lead the charge out of the Canada end. As we are 30 seconds into tonight's game, pass play down to the near side, sneaks its way through. Coming out to try to get on that is the goaltender Stokely, and he does so. He'll roll out to the far side. Played from there, as USA is going to get a quick change on right here.
It's good to see Stokely. He's out there making a diving grab at the ball just to make sure he's going to show them that he's going to own the ball.
very aggressive play to start. Gotta love seeing that out of a netminder. This one's brought in by Canada again from the near side. Tied up down along the boards as finally this one is forced loose. Canada maintains possession, pass across, goes to the far side, turning shot is blocked. Back to the way USA comes, 2-on-1 if they hurry. Quick pass across, broken up though, trying to find Blanco through. Another chance blocked in front off Anderson's shot. Now it's going to be Canada back the other way as from the near side it's Stephen Fridley down to the corner. His backhander sails up and over and into the out of bounds.
Well, it's good to see USA take advantage of some of the bad passes in the side over there and get the ball up and get the confidence in them at the beginning of the game here.
So for those of you who are new to floorball as opposed to hockey, that's a free hit that plays off that rather than a face-off. So Team USA controls back in their own zone as this will be carried on ahead towards center. That's Fusey dropping it back as it's now going to be carried on around. And finally played off far side. I believe this is Fusey with it once again. He'll play down the boards. Quick give and go right there. Fusey back into the near side for throwback. His one-timer goes wide and out of play. So a quick chance right there for USA off their free hit.
Absolutely. Our Czech player, Schrobeck, was in and he took it on the first bounce and tried to put it in on the top left corner of the net.
Be a Canada free hit out of the far side corner of their own zone. They're in the red shirts here tonight, going left to right across your screen. Played to the near side now as this is, I believe, Grenepin, and yes, it is Grenepin carrying ahead. Goes to Keiston at the near side. Tapped on back now for Laverne. Laverne back to Keiston at the near side. Keiston looking, goes across far side as it is going to be controlled by Canada back in their own zone. Up the near side, Keiston streaking ahead, comes in, turning, shoots it wide. It'll go out of bounds, and again, a USA free hit.
It's a good free hit for the USA. The Canadians are looking good, though. They're coming in with a nice passing game and trying to get the ball to the side and win the play on the baseline.
2 minutes in here, and both teams with a few shots, nothing on goal just yet. As controlled from the far side, flipped up and out of bounds off the stick of Soderbaum, and it'll be a Canada free hit. Joachim Soderbaum, the oldest player out there, 37. He's played to the near side, and now back, this is Berg for Canada. Over to the near side, now Walsh with it. Walsh on across to the far side for Lumiela. Lumiela carries back into his own zone. Far side corner goes to the near side. And it's going to be played on across, carried up ahead by Berg. Berg dropping this one back as it comes to Walsh at the near side. Walsh across to the far side. Controlled there by Lumiela. Lumiela looking to the near side, gets it on ahead for Fridley. Fridley over the center line. He'll carry it in toward the USA end, broken up and tied up at the near side half court. Battle goes on for the balls. It comes down to the corner. Berg controls for Canada. Berg out to the point. Played to the far side. Now back to Lumiela in his own zone. Back over near side. Now Berg trying to dance his way through some traffic. Sends a pass up the far side. Quick shot goes wide of the net. Rebound off the end boards. Not able to get the shot away, though, was Canada. It's tied up at the near side. Lumiela coming through with it. Gets it on ahead. Now down to the corner for Fridley. Fridley back out to get a whistle. And I believe there's a slashing call, it appeared there. Possibly a little stick-on-stick contact, and I believe it's going to be a free hit coming here. I can't see who the call was against exactly.
I didn't see it either, but what I can say is Canada's coming out with their guns, and they're playing two of their top lines and continuing with that.
Very aggressive play there as they got the chance there, and of course able to generate the free hit, but unfortunately putting it out of bounds there for Canada. And another free hit, and I believe it actually may have been off of USA players that are giving the free hit to Canada.
That's correct. USA played a little great defense there. There was three guys in the line there, and they all got low and made sure that the ball didn't come any closer to the net.
Quick tap ahead as it's played around behind the net. Broken up there nicely and directed back over along the end boards. Down to the near side now, it's going to be Strobeck tapping it ahead. Quick pass across, trying to get it toward the front. Scooping up is Goulet. First time he's really been tested here tonight as he's able to come up with that one and direct it off near side. Controlled here, this is Grenepin. He'll drop it on back as it's controlled by the defense here for Canada, as this will be Keiston playing it across the far side for Francis Laverne. Laverne looking from center, plays it on down toward the near side corner. Battle for the ball goes on there. Canada controls, put toward the front, nothing doing, but we're going to get a whistle coming here. And a little bit of contact down there, and a Canada free hit upcoming, it appears. Quick change here for both teams as well as we get the stoppage with 4:04 into period number one.
That's right. You see that the U.S. is using the first two lines back and forth here at the beginning to keep the strength on the speed on the court.
Fridley with the hit, playing it to the far side, and now played back out toward Lumiela. Lumiela and Berg, your defensive pairing here for Canada. Lumiela off to Berg at the near side. Pair of Finns back on defense here for Canada as Berg looks across to the far side for Lumiela. Lumiela looking, long pass, cross corner down to the near side. Controlled from there by Fridley. Fridley out of the corner, trying to play it around behind the net and over to the far side where it's Tristan Walsh up with it. Walsh down to Jetty. Jetty, near side corner, controls from there. maintaining possessions. He comes back around behind the net once again, directed toward the front. Nothing doing, broken up by the Americans. It's Angersting to play it ahead. Whistle those. I believe Angersting's stick may have gotten lifted. We should have a USA free hit coming right here.
Yeah, it's good to see that the intensity is already from the beginning starting the game, and it's going to, when the first ball goes down in the net, it's going to change the aspect of the game right away. It'll even get more intense.
U.S. controlling back in their own zones from the far side plate up the boards. Controlling this one, I believe that might be, that was McVeigh at the far side. He'll get it back now right in front of his own bench. McVeigh looking, he'll send it up the boards and down toward the corner. Turning with that one was the centerman Hansen, not able to do anything with it. It comes back into the U.S. zone and Stusi from the near side. Busey puts a little spin move on as he plays it on back for his defensive partner, Mikko Vahavahe. Goes off the far side, now back to Vahavahe right in front of his own net. Vahavahe now to carry ahead, he'll drop it off. It's played at the far side, controlled there by Hansen. Hansen put a little dipsy-doodle on the forechecking forwards. He sends it down to the corner. Vahavahe, the defenseman, in on the rush there. Vahavahe now out of the corner, plays it up the boards. Nobody there. Fusey's going to have to recover and quickly does so to get back on. Excellent read there by Fusey to get on the loose ball. As it comes near side, it's Srobek with it. Played back to defense for Fusey. Quick partial change on here for the Americans, as now it'll be Isaac Angerstig, the second line center here, playing behind the net. He'll dish it off far side. Americans controlled there with Soderbaum, and it comes over to the near side. Brought out of the corner here by Jonathan Moeller, and over to Soderbaum again at the far side. Soderbaum gets his pocket pick back the other way. Chance and a big save right there by Stockley. Excellent job right there by Stockley, able to pick up a bad turnover right there in front and shut it down. From the far side, back to the near side, as giving chase down to the corner is Ebersold. Ball tied up down there. Battle goes on for it. Ebersold in there, as is Berg. We get a whistle and a Canada free hit upcoming. They'll play it right off there and go to the far side. This is going to be Lumula back to Berg at the near side. Canada also only rolling two lines thus far in this game. It's played to the near side. Chance there goes wide of the net. Off the stick of Friedley, and it'll be a USA free hit.
The Canadians, they're not afraid to shoot, and that's for sure. We just, the U.S. team is looking like they're a little bit shaky with their passing, and at least in the last line, but there's a lot of game to play.
Top line out there again for the Americans. It's controlled at the far side. Over to Vahavahe for on the defense here for the USA. Vahavahe drops back for Fusey, and Fusey will control. Fusey battling with the forecheck of Cameron Buck. It's finally dropped back and played on for, I believe that was McVeigh over there. Turnover there at the far side, right in front of the USA bench, as it is controlled by Smith. Smith trying to make his way through, does so, puts the shot just wide, stays in play to the near side half boards. Back out now toward the point, turning, shooting wide of the net, and well up and over, and out of play. 6:56 into this opening period, and once again, the action just keeps on coming here early on in this game.
Sure does. Canada's got the little advantage right now. They're more offensively inclined. They've got a lot more rhythm in their play and their play strategy right now than what the U.S. has got. The U.S. has got to get the kinks out and get back going.
It's actually be a Canada free hit here as a shot was deflected. Chance there. Couldn't get good stick on that, though. It's going to be the U.S. back the other way with Angerstig at the near side. Trying to make his way through. He gets stood up, though, and the ball's taken away by Canada at the far side. Shot attempt by Friedley. Couldn't get much on his attempt either. Friedley maintaining possession, though, getting out back to the defense for Lumula and over to the near side for Berg. Berg with it now, on through center, he'll go to the far side, dropping it back as Ebersold is in on the forecheck here. Lumula controls, though, getting over to Walsh at the near side. That's Tristan Walsh, who plays it back over far side in front of the Canada bench. Tristan Walsh with it, near side, plays it on down toward the corner. And for the front, as attempt got blocked, but we're going to get a whistle here, and I believe a free hit upcoming. Excuse me. Halfway through this opening period of play, only one shot on goal according to the scoreboard. There are a lot of attempts, but nothing getting on the net very much there. That only shot belongs to Team Canada so far.
I think the defense is, for both teams have done a great job thus far. Even with the pressure that our goalkeeper from the U.S. has got, the Canadians are definitely more aggressive on the offense.
Ball played back down to the Canada end. This is going to be the other Walsh out there, Taylor Walsh, so the third line for Canada getting a little bit of time here, at least their third defensive pairing getting some time. Ball tapped out of play, and actually it's a little bit of a mixed line out there, as it is Walsh is there along with, I believe that is Laverne at the far side, so something to keep an eye on there, as Walsh, not sure if he's just getting a little bit of time in here early, or possibly an injury or something like that on the Canada side. We'll keep an eye out for it, though, as the ball goes out of play.
Exactly. They've got to mix and match there, and they got to feel their way up through the beginning of the game here to see what works better with the different lines. So it'll be interesting to see how Walsh and company puts this together.
Played back in Canada's zone. This is going to be Grenepin at the near side. Grenepin on down the boards to the near side corner. Buck gets on that one first. Buck for Canada drops this one off. Play back to the corner. This is Grenepin looking toward the front. Nothing doing. He makes it through everybody. It's the U.S. back the other way. Tapped ahead. Two-on-one chance if they hurry here for USA. McVeigh's shot shut down by Goulet. Down to the far side corner. It's McVeigh trying to put it on through. Gets to Strobeck behind the net. Strobeck, the big check forward, sends it up to the near side. Tied up there. Strobeck maintained possession, though. Lost his footing. And we'll get a whistle. I believe a stick through the legs there is the ball.
It's nice to see McVeigh finally take stride. He's had a fever the last couple of days. They didn't know if he'd get a chance to play today, but he woke up this morning feeling much better, and now he's back in action and looks good.
Big kid out there, 6'3", and USA has a couple of really good size guys there with him, and of course, Case Connor at 6'6" out there. A couple guys you can't miss very easily on the floor.
Yep, Case has got a cannon for a shot too, so hopefully get to see him a little bit later in the game.
Excellent defensive play there just a moment ago by Joaquim Soderbaum as sent back in with Canada now controlling again at the far side. Pass across, turning and shooting, a big save right there. Rebound still loses underneath the feet of the netminder Stolkley and cleared out to the far side corner. Canada maintains possession back out toward the point to Lumula. He'll settle it down in front of his own bench. Back over to the near side now, Berg with this one for Canada. Berg turning, shooting, looking for the redirect, but nothing doing as it sneaks through. Down to the near side corner. Ball tied up there for the moment. Finally comes loose up the near side half-court as you get a whistle and a free hit coming for Team USA.
Canada's still tight. They're pushing hard on the U.S. defense. We're not breaking yet, and it's good to see that we kept our composure this far in the first quarter, or first period, excuse me.
Still no scores. We are just over nine minutes into this opening period of play. USA controlling the ball back in their own zone. This is Fusey with it from the defense at the far side. Fusey now drops it back. It's controlled from there by McVeigh. His pass attempt broken up. 2-on-2 back there. Smith, he turns, he shoots, it's blocked. Near side, Grenepin picking up the rebound, trying to feed it across, finds Laverne. Laverne's shot goes wide and down to the near side corner. Canada maintains possession now. It's Keiston back in his own zone over the far side for Laverne. Laverne back over near side at the center line to Grenepin. Back for, I believe that is Keiston, and yes, it is Keiston. He'll dish it off for Grenepin. Grenepin now back to Keiston at the near side. He turns, he shoots, he puts it wide, and play. 9 minutes and 54 seconds here into this one, so almost two-thirds of the way into this opening period, and still no score. Was this what you'd expect early on in this one?
I think so. They're still feeling each other out. You know, this is always a great derby. They're really excited and, you know, a little nervous at the beginning of the game maybe, and you see Canada have shot like four or five shots wide already, and
chance here is broken up nicely though by the U.S. defense. He'll come back the other way. Nice move right there. It's Abersold. Abersold in, his shot shut down though by Goulet to a big roar from the crowd. Goulet dishes off behind the net and it's brought over to the near side. Slowly ahead by Berg. He'll go far side. Back to Berg once again, so he'll look to lead this breakout. Sends a pass on down. Gets it there for Friedley. Friedley now takes it around behind the net. Comes out far side. Friedley on the back and gets it to Berg. Berg's the near side for Walsh. Kristen Walsh with it, back out for Berg. Berg from center, goes to the far side. Brought ahead there, turning attempts and blocked on the try by Taylor Walsh. Chance here for the USA is broken up and down the corner. It's Blanco in possession. Maximus Blanco with this one. Nice little spin move right there. His shot turned aside by Goulet. Out of bounds. USA free hit, though. Excellent effort right down there with that old dipsy doodle spin move on the defense.
Yeah, it's about time that they got some excitement happening in front of the boards or in front of the net here for the USA team. And Maximus did a spin move. That's his signature spin. And hopefully they'll get some more things like that working for us that up there closer to our Canadian net.
Golden opportunity for the U.S. there off the free hit, but not able to keep possession down in the Canada zone. U.S. regroups from their own end. Now turnover, we get a whistle.
USA ball.
Free hit coming for the Americans right here. It's Vahavahe and Strobeck there to take it. Vahavahe back for Fusey. They'll go to the far side. This will be Hansen now. Hansen dishes it off into some traffic there. And Smith able to take away for Canada. U.S. quickly regains possession though with McVeigh at the far side. And we get a whistle. Canada free hit coming here as that was McVeigh and Buck got tied up a little bit down there. 11-12 here into this period. Shots on goal two apiece, but no score yet here from Fort Worth. Canada controls, it's Walsh back to Berg. He'll go to the far side for Lumula. And Lumula back to Berg here once again. Canada controlling in their own zone, flipped down to the near side corner. This is Friedley that's on it. Friedley having player draped all over him, so he's able to get it on out for Walsh. Walsh takes it back behind the net over to the far side corner. controlled it out to the point. One timer goes wide. May have hit a body in front there as well as it comes down to the near side corner. And it did go out of play there. Looked for a moment like it had deflected up and off the board, so they did say it went out, so USA ball.
Looks like USA is moving some people around on the back. Some of the third team, third line guys are in there in defense. Liam Williamson.
Turnover there for the Americans. We get a whistle and it'll be a U.S. free hit here. Not liking the call there is Stephen Friedley, but it's going to be a USA free hit at the far side corner.
Friedley's a big guy. He's a tall guy, too. He's really rangy, and he covers a lot of the field down there, so you really have to make sure your passes are right so you can get him by him.
From the far side, U.S. controls. It's Hansen playing it on back for Fusey. Fusey back to Hansen. Far side right in front of the Americans bench. He'll dish it back for Fusey once again as they make their way gradually down the floor here to the Americans.
Oh.
Pass across broken up, and it's back the other way for Canada. Nice play, though, by Bahabahe to sweep it to the far side corner. Ball up in the air and out of bounds. It'll be a Canada free hit coming here from down in the corner. It's a little sloppy play right there by the Americans. Nearly cost them, but excellent recovery right there by Bahabahe to break the play up.
Canada's coming hard. I mean, they are doing their thing. They're very intense. They're playing the ball around, the possession, hold the possession of the ball quite long.
Yeah, it's going to be Fusey now to play this one ahead for Hansen at the far side. Up the boards for McVay. Hit him in the shoes, though, unable to maintain possession. It'll be Keiston now. Keiston behind the net for Canada. Plays it off to the near side. Played now to the far side and tied up in front of the bench. Now finally coming away with this one for the Americans. I believe that is Muller down there. Muller's pass gets ahead. Stays in play, U.S. controls, but quickly scooped right back up by Canada as this is going to be Grenepin back to his own end. Grenepin with the pass over to the near side. Brought on across here, this is Buck. Buck has a dish, this one back for his defense again. This is Keiston now to carry on ahead. Keiston looking from center. He'll dish back again for Grenepin. Back here in the Team Canada zone. We have 2 minutes to play here in period number one. Still no score between the Americans and the Canadians as Grenepin looking here for Team Canada. Grenepin holding, has two forecheckers watching him very closely here, hindering his breakout attempt. Grenepin finally will carry this one ahead to the far side, right in front of the Canada bench. Dishing it back for Petrie and over to the far side. Now it'll be controlled by Berg. As Berg comes through the near side, back across for Lumula. Lumula back to Berg here at the near side down in the Canada zone. Take them 30 seconds here to get out of their end of the floor. It's finally played far side. Lumula has to regroup again. Blanco all over him. We're going to get a whistle, and I believe some stick contact is what they're going to call on that one. Yep. The hit comes across the wall. Since he gets tripped up there, tied up with Ebersold, no call either way on that one as the U.S. will maintain possession. Lay down to the far side. Blanco with it, tries to tap it away. We get a whistle and a USA free hit and a partial change here coming out on the floor for them with a minute end. 14 seconds to play here in period number one.
Yeah, well, now we got a little bit of offensive play going on. The second line has been doing a little bit better to get the ball up the floor, and things are starting to happen, so we'll see if we can get something going in the net here pretty soon from at least one of the teams.
Angerstig taps it to Blanco. His shot goes wide. Stays in play, however, down the corner. Angerstig back with it one more time. Angerstig over to the far side. No thing doing, though, and it's going to be Canada back the other way. Over now, it's going to be played on over to the near side. Controlled here by Berg for Canada. Berg now steps aside as he takes it towards center. Played on down to the near side for Bahabahe for the U.S. Bahabahe has it taken away, and Walsh will carry back behind the net for Canada as we are down to 45 seconds to play here in this opening period of play. Ball brought on ahead by Smith. He fakes the pass. Now dishes off the reel, this time to Grenepin at the near side. Grenepin over the line. Chance in front there, turned aside by the goaltender Stockley. Net came off, so we'll get a whistle here. 14:28 into the period. 32 seconds left here on the scoreboard. Controlled here by the Americans back in their own zone. This is going to be Fusey looking to lead the breakout here. Two forecheckers watching him very closely and pinning him up in the corner. Comes around behind that, plays in the near side. Turnover there as we get a whistle.
Then you have to say Jeff.
I believe a little bit of extra contact there from a Canadian player. 20 seconds left to play here in this first period of play. We'll get a free hit coming from the near side for Team USA. Bahabahe set to take this one for the Americans. Tapped on ahead as we're down to about 15 seconds to go here in the opening period of play. Still no scores. Played up the near side. Bahabahe turns, shoots. It's blocked in front. Canada controls. It's played down to the far side. It's dropped to the boards. It's going to be carried ahead. One final rush here for Canada. Put across. Broken up by Grenepin. Or on the attempt to Grenepin. Final seconds ticking down. U.S. with one final chance on net. Goulet scoops it up and holds on to it, and that'll do it for period number one. We have no score yet between Team Canada and Team USA here at this World Floorball Championship qualifier.
So what do you got in highlights?
Shots on goal thus far, 4-2 in favor of the Americans. But so far, neither team able to capitalize. Excellent defense at both ends, forcing just a lot of bad shots, keeping stuff away from the front of the net. And so with that, we have no score. We're going to be taking it down to the sideline in a moment here with Theo Blanco. And I see that we've got him there with one of our players, Alexander McVeigh, here for Team USA. So with that, let's go ahead and send this one on down to Theo at full level.
All right, Alexander, how do you feel the first period went?
I think we're playing good. I think both teams are playing really good, and it's a high-paced game, and I think it's probably very entertaining for the audience to watch. I think right now it feels like it can go either way, you know. We have some chances, they have some chances.
Exactly, it can go either way, and what do we need to do in the U.S. team to get the first ball in yet?
I think we're playing good, we have good pace, and as I said, but maybe find each other a little bit better, you know. We're still pretty new to each other, and still getting to know each other and stuff, so I mean, we're getting there, and it feels better for every shift, so hopefully by the end of tomorrow we'll be the winner out of these two games. So,
well, I'm thinking things are looking pretty good. I mean, Canada is coming out, they're looking pretty strong. They took the first 5-8 minutes of the game. A lot of pressure on our goalkeeper, but we showed a lot of great defensive stability.
Yeah, as you said, like they're strong, and we know they're a good team, and I think they probably underestimate us a little bit. I think they kind of got shocked too, like how good we are and how hard of a fighting team we are, and I think they're a little bit shaken, you know.
What do you need to do in the second period here to make things happen?
As I said before, just step things up one more level, and keep pushing and keep working hard, and I think we'll score some goals.
All right, thanks, Alexander. I appreciate your time.
All right, so once again, we are at the first intermission here tonight between Team Canada and Team USA. No score yet in this game. Of course, this is game one of a two-game series between these two squads. They will go at it again, same time, same place tomorrow night as part of this two-game weekend series. Also got the Texas Open Floorball Tournament going on as well. We're going to take a quick break right now. We'll come back to you in a few moments here on IFF Channel 1.
The family's visit to the forest inspired a beautiful question. Mother, mother, am I a tree? You tell me to stand tall. You tell me to stay rooted. I think I am a tree. My child, of course you are. But what kind of tree will you be? The kind to hug or the kind to climb? Doesn't matter what you choose, so long as you choose to be a tree that's kind.
Make the forest part of your story at a park near you. Find one at discovertheforest.org.
Every day,
millions of people are connecting.
And even though we're overcoming obstacles,
watching each other's backs,
and banding together,
We should still make an effort. To get to know each other
on a deeper level.
Father.
Cosplayer.
Mentor.
Actor.
It's time we take a step forward.
Come together
and discover
how accepting our differences
can make us stronger.
There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth. without any bread, and kiss them all soundly.
Lights out.
Good night.
And put them to bed. Hunger is a story we can end. End it at feedingamerica.org.
How prepared is your family if a tornado shows up at your doorstep, or a flood, or a hurricane? You can't just turn away a natural disaster. That's why it's important to go to ready.gov/plan now. It has the tools and tips you need to make an emergency plan with your family. So if disaster comes knocking,
let's go.
You'll be ready to help keep your family safe.
It's just a pizza.
Yes.
Make a plan today.
Once again, here from the Texas Christian University Recreation Center in Fort Worth, Texas. Welcome back to our broadcast here of the World Floorball Championships North American Qualifiers between Team USA, Team Canada, here on YouTube IFF Channel 1. I am Drew Pelto, joined once again here by Theo Blanco. And, well, Theo, this is where we'd usually talk about a recap of all the scoring from the period. And, well, I mean, we combined for 6 shots on goal only, so a remarkable defensive game here to start here between these two squads.
I think that's a little bit of the strategy. You don't want to get something in the net early from either the team. So I think the strategy has been to back yourself into the goal and not let anything happen. There's been great defensive plays on both sides of the court, and I think the jitters are getting out, and Canada's looking tough. I mean, Canada has come out and shown a lot of aggressive ball, especially forward. They're very good at stretching out the defense of the Americans and getting the ball up the court.
Well, these two teams have gone up against each other in their history 13 times now. So this is the 14th matchup here. Canada leads the all-time series 7-6, but that's a lot closer than I would have thought when I first started looking at some of the numbers, because, I mean, Canada won the last head-to-head matchup they had for a win-or-go-home qualifier. But aside from that, I mean, the scores have always been very close. Canada 5-4, Canada 3-2, and USA 1-0 are the last 3 times these two teams have faced each other. So it always seems like it's going to be a really close game between them, and I mean, you never know really what you're going to expect. I mean, you see a USA 8-1 score in there at one point as well. So I got to say, I like what I'm seeing so far. I've always preferred, as a former goalie myself, I like lower scoring games out there whenever I can.
Exactly. It makes things a little bit more exciting toward the end of the game, and this is kind of you got to hand it to the people and the organizations of both Canada and the U.S. They've created better floorball situations. They're growing the sport slowly but surely, but it's coming on more and more. And I think just events like this and these big world championship series that have been around the last, say, 15 years have really opened up eyes. And I look forward to see the U.S. and Canada show that North America is going to be a big part of the world championships in the near future.
Neither of these countries exactly with a huge pedigree in the floorball world. Well, when you compare them to like Finland and Sweden, of course, who are always the top two teams, it seems, out there, and been playing the sport pretty much forever. But definitely, like you said there, I mean, it's good to see that it's definitely growing here in both of these countries, in the U.S. and Canada. Several great programs all over the place. You know, we highlight the NTFA in Austin. You mentioned Chicago has a great program. Out in California, there's several of them. And even a couple of East Coast ones. I know, like MIT, for example, I believe is where it kind of got its start in the United States.
Well, you know, there's a lot of Finnish and Swedish settlers that came over here. They came over here for work and stuff like that. They played quite high divisions in the United, in Sweden and their home countries, and even the Czechs now and the Swiss are coming over here and living and working, and they want to still be a part of the organization, and they want to build up the youth programs, and it's really important to get this. I moved to Sweden 30 years ago myself, and it was at about the stage where the U.S. Floorball is now, but I think when the U.S. puts their mind to it and Canada puts their mind to it, it's going to go quite quick.
Being half finished myself, it's always I like highlighting them, and their little Sisusumi thrown in there.
Sisumi.
We're about a minute away, just under a minute away from getting period number 2 underway. Theo, what do you see here coming up in the second period here between these two squads? They switch sides.
I think the U.S. is going to try to control the ball a little bit more and not be so antsy to get it up the court and find a decent a corner and slot to put it in so we can move it up there. I think Canada's going to stick to their guns because they've been pretty successful moving the ball around and getting it up into the net. They just had some shots and gone wide. Thankfully for the U.S., but it's been a tough defensive battle, and I think the defenses are going to continue to do the things that they're doing, but the offense for the U.S. has to change things up a little bit and be a little bit more intense, a little bit more aggressive.
The actual shot on goal totals 4-2 from the opening period, but seemed like, I mean, a lot of shots coming off the Canada sticks there. Just, I mean, U.S. doing a good job of getting a piece of them to direct them out of play. Doing a good job to even just shut some stuff down, blocking stuff in front. So definitely a lot of excitement, but I mean, U.S. is just kind of stepping up and doing a good job there of snuffing things out when they have to.
Exactly. It's nice to see this Dario Fauci is back from Switzerland. He was with the U19 2 years ago, and that's when he was really noticed. But he's been playing in the top league in Switzerland now for the past couple of seasons, and it shows with his confidence with the ball and his technique ability with the stick, and hopefully that'll be something that'll help them get the ball up the court as well.
One of eight players for Team USA making their U.S. men's national team debut here tonight. So you mentioned before the young team out there for Team USA, but they have not shown it so far.
Exactly, and I think that the people around the country in the United States have really put together good programs in Fresno and Utah and Colorado and Orlando and Chicago, definitely, and absolutely in Texas. And it'll be good to see that this blows itself up a little bit. The World Games are coming in the summer, and the U.S. and Canada are going to be both a part of that, so it'll be the top 10 teams in the world.
Well, we're about ready to get things underway here in period number two. Just waiting on the scoreboard clock to be reset to the 15 minutes. Actually, my mistake with counting upwards. I always forget that here. I'm used to it being hockey where they count downwards. But we're underway here. As controlled by Team Canada, they'll get a free hit with Granepin to play it back. And we'll stop and they'll redo it from the appropriate spot there at the far side of the floor. 6 seconds into the period, Canada controlling the ball. Back over the near side, Keiston with this one for Team Canada, over to Grenepin at the near side. Grenepin, the left-hand centerman, will carry it off to the near side, tapping it on back for, I believe that was Smith. Now down to the near side, Grenepin battling with an American player, getting a whistle. I believe that was Schrobeck with a little stick contact there, and it'll be Team Canada controlling on the free hit. Smith to the far side, picked up there and controlled back over the near side for Smith once again. Smith now down toward the near side corner, has it on the backhand. Turning, putting toward the front. Scooped up there by Snokely. He'll send a long pass all the way down. Trying to get to it, there's McVay as we get a collision far side. Flipping over the boards is a Canadian player. That was Keiston, and he's a bit slow to get up there. He may have landed awkwardly there out of bounds.
Yeah, McVay, he sliced him on the inside, then went back on the outside. I think it kind of confused him a little bit. He got a little shove in there, and Keiston flew over the boards.
We'll keep an eye on him there, make sure everything's all right. It's played over in front of Canada's bench. This is Lumiela to carry it ahead. His pass attempt will be broken up down to the corner. Getting a stick on that one for the Americans was Soderbaum. Far side, I believe that is Soderbaum that is still in there on that. It seems that's Williamson.
Williamson.
Yep. So Liam Williamson listed on the third line here, getting some time here in this second period of play. USA controls off the free hit to the far side. I mean, the second line forwards out there appears here as this one's poked away. It's going to be Canada back the other way, 2-on-3. U.S. with the advantage here. It's played to the near side. Tied up there, finally back out for Berg at center. He'll go near side as this is going to be controlled by Friedley. Friedley on down, broken up, tied up here as the Americans will finally force it up the boards and ahead with Angerstig. Angerstig near side, brings it around, and fires it wide down the far side corner where it's 8 to Lumiela to pick up for Canada. Lumiela at the far side, playing it back now behind the net for Berg, his defensive partner. Quick partial change here for Canada as it's Berg sending it up the near side and down toward the corner. Battle going on for the ball there. Canada able to control it back out to the point here. This one is going to be Smith. Back down for Buck, and we get a whistle. Canada with a free hit coming. Just in case we didn't mention before, the officials for tonight's game are Thomas Ellis and Janne Sjogren, both of Finland. As he tipped off the free hit there, gets blocked, tied up at the boards. Chance there toward the front, nothing doing. Another try there. Grenepin couldn't control as it goes down to the far side corner. We get a whistle here and some contact. Canada with a free hit coming out of this corner.
Canada's still aggressive. They're really making a move on the net and making things happen.
quick tap on the free hit, played to the front. Loose pucks or loose balls sitting in the crease. We get a whistle here. And I believe we're going to get an American free hit coming here as a little scramble in front right there. First time we've really seen some action down there close to the crease here at either end.
Exactly. I think this is going to be a little bit more contact in this period here. They've played the ball around quite a bit, and now it's getting a little more frustrated. Who's going to get the first goal?
Honestly, got the free hit, played it to the near side, now back to the far side, but Canada able to intercept. It's Lumiola back to Berg. Berg to the far side. He's got Lumiola behind him. He'll instead go far to near side. Shot there, turned aside. Nicely there off the mask of Stokely. And from the near side, the U.S. will be back the other way. Chance to transition to the front as Angerstig can't quite get the stick on it. Far side, it's Aversold up with it again here for the Americans. Aversold back over to Moeller at the near side. Moeller to the near side, played at the boards here by Blanco. Blanco down to the corner, turning, shooting high, and over the boards. Excellent attempt right there by the U.S., just putting it a couple wide, but again, I mean, just picking up the offensive chances here early on in the second period. From the near side, Canada controls out of their own zone as it's going to be Kaisten to carry ahead. Kaisten drops back for Smith. Smith looking across to the far side. And finally, it'll be Grenepin now to control for the Canadians. He's got Laverne at the near side. He'll send it on to him. Fakes up the boards. Now retreats back through his own half. Back to the near side again. This is Smith now across to the far side. And finally, played on down to the near side boards. Grenepin with it, putting it across, but right through Smith. Couldn't quite get the stick on it. It's the Americans back in the way now with McVay. McVay, his pass broken up. Maintains the same play. We get a big collision there. Kaisten and McVay, who went at each other earlier, that resulted in Kaisten going over the boards. This time it's Kaisten sending him over the boards, and going to draw the ire of several people out there on the floor.
Yeah, that was sure a payback there. I mean, that happens in floorball, and it's a fine point where what's going to be called a foul or not a foul. When you go to the World Championship Series, it gets rough out there, and they don't call fouls that often, so it was kind of blatant, that one. That was payback.
Yep. Just saw the replay of it right there. Yeah, it was well after McVay lost control of the ball, but are they going to send? No, it's going to be still, I believe, still 5-on-5. Oh, wait, no, we do have a penalty up on the boards here, so it's going to be at the 3:11 mark of the second period. So it's going to be the U.S. going up on the power play here as it is Kaisten going to the box. So U.S. power play here. Play down to the near side. Back to the high slot. It's going to be Fusey to the far side. Boarding, I believe, is what they said the call was. That shot is broken up. It's going to be Canada back the other way, but Vaha Vahe on this one, and we get another whistle. And a free hit coming down in the Americans' offensive side of the floor. It's going to be a Canada free hit, though. Minute 43 to go on this man advantage.
I think the referees are trying to control the game a little bit now, just slow it down a little bit because it's getting kind of feisty.
Going to get a free hit here for the Americans as it's going to be taken from right in front of the U.S. net. Minute 35 to go here on the man advantage as it's played off to the far side for McVay. McVay in front of the bench. Plays down, gets it back now. Plays back out toward the point for Fusey. Fusey looks to the near side for Vaha Vahe. Cycled on down to the near side. Back out to Fusey. Fusey from just inside center. He'll retreat a little bit, looks far side for Hansen, back to Fusey. Fusey looking, goes to Hansen again at the far side. And now over to Vaha Vahe as they cycle it high. Chance there is blocked, comes to the near side. U.S. maintains possession, though, with Schobeck. Schobeck now has it tapped away by Smith. We get a whistle and a Canada free hit coming here. A little extra contact there from Schobeck with 106 to go on this power play for the Americans.
The Swedes are not moving the ball like they should around quick. It should be one touch, one touch, one touch, but they're... they're slowing it down a little bit, and that you can't do that on the power play.
Canada on the free hit, they'll send it on down the length of the floor back to the near side corner. Battle goes on for the ball, U.S. controls it, now it's sent to center for Fusey. Fusey far side, down to the boards for Hansen, back out to Fusey. He's got Vaha Vahe at the near side, puts a torque up front. It's Hansen now controlling. Back to McVay, he turns, he shoots, it's blocked in front. Canada tries to clear, cannot do so, that's Fusey to the far side. Fusey holding from there. Looking toward the front, now goes back out to the point for Vaha Vahe over the near side for Schrobeck. Schrobeck turning, shooting, save, made, rebound, clear to the near side, and it's Walsh to put it off the boards and out in the U.S. end with 35 to go on this man advantage. Back to the far side now, Fusey, one more time for the Americans, sends it on down to the corner. McVay walking in, McVay from a tough angle has it go off of his body, comes to the near side, Vaha Vahe able to keep it in. Vaha Vahe toward the front, it's Hansen turning, shooting wide of the net. And we'll get another stoppage here, just about 5 minutes into period number two. 18 seconds remaining here on this man advantage for the Americans. Canada controls, though, out of their own zone. back down to the near side. Pinned up down in the corner. Finally brought toward the front. Three Americans on this one. They finally come away with it. But now it's Smith up with it. Tinkerly there. A chance of scoring for the Canadians. Short-handed goal. That was Cedric Grenepin.
With 5 seconds left in the penalty period, sadly enough that the U.S. are hanging their heads a little bit on that one, but Canada was awake, got it up, and off of a missed ball there, and an easy shot right up into the net.
Grenepin with Smith on the assist, shorthanded. And so that'll give Canada a 1-0 lead. So not the start the Americans wanted to see here of this period, but see what they can do here. They've got 5 seconds still left in the man advantage there, as you pointed out. So a chance possible for one final attempt here as Lee Ongersing take the draw. It's controlled by the Canadians, though, and it's lifted and sent the length of the floor. Muller back with it at the far side. He's got Walsh all over him. We get a whistle and a free hit as well, actually contact there from Walsh. The Americans will control it now. Back to 5-on-5 play now as returning from the box is defenseman Keisler.
Canada's done a great job of backing up and using their bodies against the Swedes, the younger Swedish guys, and it's paying off for them.
Free hits come out of the corner here, and actually they're going to move back up to more toward the center line here. For the Americans, they'll control far side, turning, shooting, deflection goes wide, and it'll bounce its way over the boards. 5:25 into this period, number two. 1-0, Canada still on top here against the Americans. Chance toward the front, broken up. It's going to be Canada controlling back there with Friedley. He has his pocket picked by Williamson. He'll settle it at the far side. Taken away by Friedley. Friedley looking to the front. Nothing doing. As it comes back out to Berg. Berg turning, putting it across to the far side. Lumiola winds and fires and scores. It's Lumiola on the blast from the point. It's a 2-0 lead here for the Canadians. As you see the replay right here, just put across. He just winds up on the one-timer. Picks that top corner there.
Yeah, he sure does. He finds the little gap up the top. Our U.S. defensive guys didn't get low enough when the shot came, and it opened up a little space there to get right up into the corner of the net.
So a 2-0 lead here. We'll get the assist on that here in a moment. I believe it may have been Berg on the assist now that I think about it. And so 2-0 now, 5:39 here into the second period. So two goals in the span of just over 30 seconds here for the Great White North. Faceoff controlled by the Canadians back in their own zone. This is going to be Keisten playing it to the near side. He'll play it off to Grenepin, and Grenepin will carry ahead. Strobeck watching him, so he'll dish it now back for Smith. Matthew Smith carries it on ahead. He'll look off to the near side, now going far side, now holds, dropping it back. This is going to be Keisten. Keisten kicking it back now. This one is controlled by the Canadians with Laverne back for Grenepin one more time. Grenepin now leading this breakout. He'll go to the near side and finally turning and carrying ahead. Keisten putting it toward the front, broken up. And back the other way, the Americans come. 3-on-1 if they hurry. It's Strobeck on the near side. His pass broken up by Laverne. Excellent effort there coming back by the defenseman, Francis Laverne.
Strobeck had the shot. He should have taken it right away, but he wanted to be unselfish and give it in the back in the middle and maybe get the go again on it.
Controlled here by Canada, back behind their own net. Off to the near side, it is Lowry Berg. He'll carry it and play it up the near side boards, down toward the near side corner. Battle going on for it there. Canadians away with it for a moment. Trying to cover it there was Stokely, but it's had swatted away before he could get to it. We get a whistle. We've got a Canadian player down in the corner. I believe that is one of the Walshes that is there. And he may be bleeding a bit there as he's got the hand up to the face there.
Looks like a nosebleed.
Yep. Not sure what happened there, if there was a collision or a high stick or something down there. But either way, he's going to have to go and get that closed up. Make sure we don't have any prima facie evidence down there on the floor or anything. But yeah, he's getting looked at by the trainer down there. That would be number 55, Tristan Walsh.
Tristan Walsh.
Got twin brothers out there, Tristan Walsh and Taylor Walsh. And fortunately playing on different lines, it looks like, for the most part here tonight. So hopefully we won't get those two out there mixed up very often. Because I remember calling a hockey game where we had three guys, last name Johnson, all on one team, all on the ice at one point. So.
Well, that first goal has been really important for the Canadians. It gave him a lot more energy. It created another momentum for it. And the U.S. has got to break that momentum and break that energy to get back in the game.
Looks like it's going to be a U.S. free hit the way they're lining up here. So possibly a great opportunity here to kind of settle things down a little bit, try to get the mind back into attack mode here, and kind of caught them back on their heels for a bit here, but we'll see if they can open it up here as it's controlled by Ongersting to the far side. Brought on by Blanco. He'll drop it back now to the far side. Back to Blanco once again. Blanco holding. He'll now bring it toward the middle. His pass broken up quickly maintained possession, though, was Williamson, getting it back down to Blanco, back to Abersold, and out to the far side, where I believe this is Mueller to play down toward the corner. Controlled there by the Canadians, brought to the near side, as this is the defenseman Laverne bringing it behind the net. He'll play a long pass on ahead for Buck. Buck has it tapped away. Nice recovery there by Mueller, as brought over to the near side. Turning chance there by Grenepin is shut down by the netminder Stokely, and he'll dish it off to the far side corner.
Stokely's been playing well. Yeah, I mean, he's got the two in the net by him, but you know that he's got to get his help from the defensive guys.
It's Vahavahe now off to the far side, as it'll be controlled by the Americans with Fusey. Back for Vahavahe. He'll bring it over to the near side, looking back over to Fusey at the far side in front of the American bench. He holds there for a moment. He's having to battle a forecheck there from Friedley. Finally spins away from him and carries towards center. Back to the far side now, controlled on ahead. This is Hansen taking it down. Hansen putting the brakes on his pass, broken up, and he regains possession again off the far side boards. Hansen poked away from him, courtesy of, I believe that is number 15, Taylor Walsh. We get a whistle, it's going to be a Canadian free hit.
Boy, oh boy, I said Friedley, he's just all over the place. He's rangy, he's blocking passes, he's blocking the momentum, he's blocking the offense of getting up the court. It's great to see a long, tall guy like that just stretching himself all over the place.
Canadians control now with Berg at center. He'll drop it on back for it to Lumula. Lumula through his own end. He'll take a look from the near side, now kind of back toward the middle, right in front of his own net. Looking far side, now holds once again. Trying to get some help here from his teammates. Finally puts a long pass through and redirecting it wide. It was Friedley. Ball still loose, comes out near side. Back out towards center. It's Lumula to control again for the Canadians. Lumula looking. He'll take it on down toward the center spot as he'll come over to Berg, and he'll carry on through now for the Canadians. Off to the near side, this is controlled by Friedley. He's met by a body right there. That's Strobeck. A couple of big guys there coming together on that one. Battle for the ball as it's won out by the Americans for a moment. And finally goes up and out of play.
Yeah, Friedley's a factor. You can see the Canadians, they're trying to get the ball down deep into the right in front of the goalkeeper with a big guy trying to battle out the other defensive guy and just kind of knock it in. So they've changed the strategy a little bit. They're really trying to get it up to the big guy in the middle.
Americans control, quickly cycling around the outside down to the far side corner for Abersold. He has it taken away, though, and it's Canada back again at the near side. Tapped away from Keiston, now controlled up the near side boards for Laverne. His attempt is broken up, and a shot by Angerstig is deflected wide. Out far side now, the Canadians bring in. Americans intercept him. Angerstig trying to take on four at once. Nothing doing there as Laverne will pick it up for Canada. And coming to the near side once again for Cedric Grenepin. Grenepin with the first goal here tonight for the Canadians, shorthanded earlier in this period. He controls, batting back and forth there with Keiston, who will now carry it on in front of his own net. Keiston looking from the far side in front of the benches. He's being pursued by a couple of Americans. As finally it's played back down to the near side, and again Canada will regroup and try to break out again. Grenepin from the near side, he'll look across, now carrying it on through his own zone, dropping it back. And brought forth by, I think that is Smith over there. And yes, it was Smith playing it to the far side now. Brought in over by Laverne, down to the corner for Buck. Buck having it tapped away, Americans up with it. And back the way will be Mueller to lead this one off. Quick attempt here, as it's going to be Abersold trying to bring it back behind his own net. He'll go far side, where it's controlled by the defenseman Williamson. On across to Hansen, near side, had it go off the boards behind him though, and he can't quite recover on it. Grenepin now for Team Canada, back behind his net. So we have 10. We are 10 minutes into this second period of play. 2-0. Canada still on top. As Lumula will play it off to the far side. Lumula back with it now. Lumula holds, looking, playing it up the boards at the near side, down toward the corner. Canada maintains possession with this one, trying to put it toward the front. USA intercepts 2-on-2. Back to the right to Strobeck. Has it taken away? Comes back to Hansen though. Hansen turning, shooting, turned away by the netminder J.R. Coulet. Far side, we get another little collision down there and. They'll reset the board to 10:31 into period number two.
The U.S. has got to capitalize on those kind of like fast breaks, and they need to get the ball into the net to get it back. But they're being aggressive. They're doing what they got to do to get the ball closer to the net. So it's positive for them.
Canada controls here as it's Smith looking off to the far side. His pass broken up. He regains and sends it on net, where it is Stokely to quickly pick that one up. Stokely trying to get possibly a closeness penalty there, but not able to do so as he'll send it on down. There comes McVay. McVay, chance, save, rebound, put just high over the crossbar. And oh, what an individual effort right there by Alexander McVay.
Nice move by Alexander. He tried to do both get it into the side, and then he got it back right in his blade, and he just tried to tip it in there, but it went right up over the top of the net.
See the replay right there. I think it maybe even got off the stick of Keist in there at one point, but the goaltender, Goulet, I think got his leg up on that, so nice jumping play right there. There's a chance there, and putting it wide was Angerstig. Oh, man, a golden opportunity there for the Americans, but not able to.
That's floorball, my friends. That's floorball right there. Let's get the three passes in within a second, and then that's how you're supposed to play it.
Had the goaltender down, but not able to do anything. We have a battle for the ball at the far side. Blanco up with it, turning and shooting. It's blocked before it got very far. Swept away there. That was Gredepin coming in. That's going to be a little excessive contact, I believe, and a free hit for the Americans. Great chance right here for an offensive
right
ball.
There.
Free hit, and he scores! Maximus Blanco with that little spin move you were talking about. Gets it on his stick, turning, shooting, and I mean, when you're a goalie, you cannot even see where that ball is coming from when they spin like that.
Yeah, but he's got that. That's his signature play, and he did the same thing in the World Championships, and it's hard to stop that. You can't see the goalie, can't see where the ball's coming from, and beautiful shot up into the net.
So 2-1 our score. Timeless goal is the 11:34 mark. Even strength goal here to make it a 2-1 lead. We'll get the assist on that here in a moment. But like I said, came right off a free hit there. It may have been Angerstig on that one. I couldn't see who had the initial contact of it. We'll get back out to center here as the ball's controlled here by the Canadians. Berg at the near side, a 2-1 score. The Americans down here in the second period. Controlled by Berg, he'll carry ahead for the Canadians. It's going to be Colin Kanai-Abersol who had the assist on that.
I think it was Angerstig.
Played from the far side. McVeigh trying to play it across. And over to the near side board. Just slow rolling ball there. Tied up by Vahavahe, but quickly loses out to the Canadians. Shot attempt is blocked and comes down to the near side boards. Battle for it there. It's the Canadians controlling now with Walsh behind the net. Walsh has it knocked away. Americans maintain possession now at the near side corner. Good to see Tristan Walsh back out there after he got a cut up earlier. So we get a whistle here. As we're down to, we're at the 12:19 mark here of period number two, so about 2 minutes and 41 seconds remaining here in this middle frame.
Well, the U.S. needed that to get some energy. They're really playing tough now, and Canada's got to respect the fact that the things have changed here, momentum-wise.
From the far side, back to Vahavahe. He'll go back to the far side one more time. I believe it might be Muller, who's played ahead, broken up by Walsh. He'll carry back for the Canadians. Straight through center. Walsh to the far side, turning, shooting, gets blocked in front and cleared to the far side. Laverne able to hold up for the Canadians, sending it down along the end boards. Battle for the ball going on there. One player from each team in on it. That is Fusey back there for the Americans. We get a whistle, and I believe it's going to be a Canadian free hit. And it will be from the far side. Canadians with a partial change right here as it's brought across by Gredepin and over to the near side for Keiston. Keiston back to Gredepin, and he'll circle back behind his own net. Ebersole down on the forecheck, really coming after him down there at the near side corner. Keiston able to get away with it, though, goes to the near side for Laverne. His shot goes up and over the boards. Just under 2 minutes to play here in period number two, and another free hit coming for the Americans out of their own zone.
Yeah, the U.S. has stepped it up. You can see that. The Canadians, they're holding their composure, though. They're not letting them come in there on their side of the field.
Played on down toward the corner. Americans in possession with McVeigh. Trying to look on the backhand. Takes back the forehand now at the far side corner. Trying to come around. Nice play by Laverne. He will get whistled for it. So that's usually the thing. If you make a really great defensive play like that in close, you're probably going to get whistled for it.
Well, it was a good defensive play. The only thing he did is stuck his foot out and tripped him up there. The last thing he did, and that's what he got called for.
Free hit at the far side as the Americans will have this one. Tried to play it through there was McVeigh, but broken up nicely there by Laverne. And dish off to Gredepin as we're down to a minute and a half to go here in period number two. Back over to the near side board. Just played ahead, chance in front, broken up. Rebound out to the near side. Canadians still controlling as played on down toward the corner. Back now behind the net. This is Muller trying to play it out toward the near side. Americans maintain possession of it as this is Fusey back around behind the net and over to the far side for... I believe that is Fusey to play it ahead now. It's either that is Muller that's playing it ahead down to the corner. Back now for the Canadians. We're down to a minute to play here in period number two. As the ball's brought behind the net here for Gredepin. Gredepin at the far side. Dishes out back for Berg for the Canadians. They try to maintain possession here all the way up to the final horn if they can and get themselves one more chance. comes near side for Petrie, battling Vahavahe. Vahavahe able to win out for the Americans, putting on the brakes down there. Now just round over to the far side corner. It'll be the Canadians to carry this one on out, as this is going to be Lumula, the defenseman, slowing things down here. 30 seconds to play here in period number two. Walsh playing it on back, controlled there by Berg. And again, the Canadians just very slowly taking their time here as it's brought ahead by Berg, splitting through the forechecking forwards. Chance there, turned aside by the netminder. Stokely, another chance in front, broken up off the stick of an American. We get a whistle, 14:45 on the clock, 15 seconds left to play here in this opening period of play. It's going to be a U.S. free hit upcoming here. So one final chance for the Americans right here. Shots on goal, 8 apiece so far through this one. Canadians lead by a score of 2-1, though. Americans finish their change here. Quick pass off to the far side. Final 10 seconds of this period as it's broken off. Canadians back the other way. Americans regroup in their own zone. QC with it, 3 to go. His pass attempt goes up in the air, and that should do it for period number 2. Final horn sounds. We have a 2-1 score between the Canadians and the Americans. Canada on top thus far. Shots on goal, 6 in this period for Canada. 4 saves for Sebastian Stokely. At the other end for the Americans, 4 shots on goal, 3 saves for J.R. Goulet. We'll give you a scoring recap later on during this intermission. In a moment here, we're going to send things down to floor level, where we'll have Theo Blanco talking to another player here with us. Not sure if it's going to be a Canadian or an American. I believe we're going to be talking to a Canadian player. And it looks like, yes, we'll have Matt Smith on with us. So we'll go ahead and send things on down to Theo Blanco at ice level, or at floor level.
All right, Matthew, you've got 2 goals in this period, and then turning things on for the Canadian team. How does it feel?
Definitely feels good to get on the board, and there's no reason to stop now. We still got to play them tomorrow. We're looking at this as a 2-game set, so we definitely want to keep putting the pedal on the gas and put more balls in the net when we can.
So what do you think your advantage is right now? You got 6 or 7 guys from the same team. Does that help you guys out?
Yeah, we definitely have chemistry with certain group, and that plays into our game a lot, helps that we've played together. But other than that, our advantages are that we're committed and we want to win. So
what do you guys got to do to take this home in the third period?
Not give up. Still a long game, still 15 more minutes today and 45 more tomorrow. So nothing's over.
All right, Matthew, thank you very much.
I appreciate it. Take care.
Good luck in the third.
All right, we'll have Theo rejoining us here in a moment as he'll come back up on floor level. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from this second period of play, as this is the first goal scored by the Canadians. Grenepin right there off the pass from Smith. Just goes and finds a spot on off to Stokely's right. See right here from the angle behind the net, and Grenepin comes through with it. Right there, just off a steal, comes through and just able to whip one right inside the post there for a 1-0 Canada lead. There's a shorthanded goal as well. Later on in the period, of course, Kent takes a 2-0 lead off that blast right there from Antu Lumiola. Far side just looks in, picks a corner, and goes top left corner there on Stokely to give the Canadians a 2-0 lead. U.S. strikes back, though, as you saw right there. That was Blanco from Eversold, I believe. Yeah, it was Eversold, as that was Angersig that was down by the net there. And so that made a 2-1 lead here for the Canadians. Americans getting one back late in period number 2. So once again, it was Grenepin from Smith at the 5:06 mark, Lumula from Berg at the 5:39 mark, and then the Americans with Blanco from Eversold at the 11:34 mark. As we stand, a 2-1 game right now. Shots on goal, 8 apiece, 6 for the Americans, six for the Americans in the period, 4 for the Canadians. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back with you here in a moment on YouTube IFF Channel 1.
The family's visit to the forest inspired a beautiful question. Mother, mother, am I a tree? You tell me to stand tall. You tell me to stay rooted. I think I am a tree. My child, of course you are. But what kind of tree will you be? The kind to hug or the kind to climb? Doesn't matter what you choose, so long as you choose to be a tree that's kind.
Make the forest part of your story at a park near you. Find one at discovertheforest.org.
There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth without any bread and kissed them all soundly.
Lights out.
Good night.
And put them to bed. Hunger is a story we can end. End it at feedingamerica.org.
How prepared is your family if a tornado shows up at your doorstep, or a flood, or a hurricane? You can't just turn away a natural disaster. That's why it's important to go to ready.gov/plan now. It has the tools and tips you need to make an emergency plan with your family. So if disaster comes knocking,
let's go.
You'll be ready to help keep your family safe.
It's just a pizza.
Yes.
Make a plan today.
Most of my family, they never graduated high school or even let alone go to college, so I'm trying to break that barrier.
My daughter Brooklyn was also a motivation for me to go back to school.
It's been so amazing to be able to give our child what we kind of pictured us having, even though we didn't really have that.
I've been in foster care my whole life.
He's so strong to just be able to like leave that all behind and still be able to take care of his daughter and be a good husband.
Every day after work, went straight to school, studied hard, and it paid off. I could not have done it alone.
We've been through so much in our life, and he never used that as an excuse, but as motivation to do better.
I see the future is really bright for me. The high school diploma is just added to the confidence, and now I feel unstoppable.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Coming back to you once again here from the TCU Rec Center in Fort Worth, Texas. 2-1 is our score through 30 minutes of play between the Canadians and the Americans. Team Canada on top. But, kind of a tough start there for the Americans there. Canadians getting two goals in there, but Americans striking back though midway through the period.
Yeah, I mean, it was back and forth there for the first, say, 5 minutes, and then Canada got two back-to-back within a minute, and that's a tough one to come back from, and just giving the Canadians a little bit more energy throughout the rest of it. Then we were able to get one back there on them, which makes things a little bit easier for them going into the third period.
See right here is that first goal from the Canadians, shorthanded, and Grenepin just off a turnover. They're able to find a little spot up top.
Yep, he won a turnover there. You got to give him credit. He fighted for the ball, took it across the middle, and found the little opening up into the left-hand corner of the net.
Then about 30 seconds later, it was Lumula's blast right there going up high on Stokely up to that corner. Made it a 2-0 lead for the Canadians.
And if you watch, there's Max's play there, but the Canadians, look at this one more time.
Yep.
The Canadians did a great job of scoring in the second goal. They took advantage of the U.S. guys didn't get low on defense, and it's harder for the goalie also when people are standing straight up.
A couple nice saves there by Stokely as well. We talked about the great play out of him, and of course back the other end by Goulet. A couple nifty saves right here. As you see one that he makes right there, just coming across and keeping the leg out and keeping the hand up.
Yeah, the goalies on both ends are doing a great job, and we've had a couple of chances to get the ball in the net the first, before Maximus got his shot in, and that was a beautiful shot there off the top of the crossbar, we put one or two of those things in, and we're either on top or we're equal with them.
Definitely seemed like a lot more action here in this period. I mean, 10 shots on goal compared to the 6 in the opening period there. Definitely good to see that picking up a little bit. What do you see here for this third period as we are about to get that underway in a few moments?
Well, as I spoke to the Canadian captain there between the halves, I think that just like he said, he says we just got to keep the intensity up throughout the whole third period, and I think both teams have to do that to get it in there. The U.S. Have to be a little bit more stick control, do the one-touch thing that they did that got them in a couple chances there to score a goal, but they just missed wide or just missed off the crossbar. So I think that both teams are playing for both games. They know that the total score is the most interesting, but it'd be nice to see that they keep it close because it keeps it real, real exciting for us.
One thing I want to highlight before we get this third period underway, the work that went into putting this floor down here at this arena. We mentioned before, just a great venue right here at TCU. But they just got this floor here, a brand new Gerfloor flooring installed in. It took them 3 days, 15 workers, and 180 man hours. A $60,000 investment there for USA Floorball. And so anybody who's watched Floorball, of course, has probably seen this floor before, but this is the first time that we've seen this in USA Floorball here, to have this great Olympic standard quality floor being used out there.
Yes, it is, and it'll be the same floor being used for the World Games coming up in July, I think, and it's a floor that's notorious. You see it all over Sweden and Finland and Czech and even in Switzerland. So I mean, this is a floorball floor, but you can do anything on it. You can play basketball, you can play indoor soccer, you can play whatever. But it's a good floor. It's good for your joints and everything else, and it's a fast-paced floor to make the game that much more exciting.
The whole thing apparently weighs 5 metric tons, which is, wow. I was kind of amazed when Callie Carlson was telling me about that stat. They're just like, whoa, that's, I mean, only 3 days they had to get this down and look at it. I mean, it just looks absolutely perfect out there.
Yeah, it's beautiful, and they did a heck of a job there. I was watching them the other night and them rolling it out. I mean, it took man hours and man muscle hours, and there's a lot of tired people, I can tell you that, and sore after they rolled this thing out the other night.
All right, just about ready to get the third period underway. We've got about a minute up on the clock right now. So once again, a quick scoring recap for you. The 5:06 mark, shorthanded. Grenepin from Smith got the scoring going for the Canadians. 33 seconds later, it was Lumula on a blast from the far side point. Off an assist from Lowry Berg to make it 2-0. And finally, the Americans coming through. Didn't get a chance to talk much about Maximus Blanco's goal there off that little spin move there. But we talked about it a little bit off the air there that, I mean, anytime you can use a body as a shooter to kind of shield where your shot's coming from, it's great. And if you can use your own for it, that's even better.
Yeah, it's a tough shot for any goalie because it's hard to see if he's going to continue on to the corner of the court or if he's going to dish it off to somebody else or he's going to shoot it. I mean, it's a tough one, and people aren't ready for that one. None of the Canadians went down. It left things a lot open, and he got it in the back of the net.
Only one penalty to talk about from the opening period. By the way, it's Colin Kenai-Eversold with the assist on that goal for the Americans. Only one penalty to talk about so far, as it was Kaisten got 2 minutes for boarding at the 3:11 mark, which led to that Canadian shorthanded goal. Scoreboard is ready to go here in the third period. We've got the triple zeros on. Theirs will count up to 15. And we are underway with the Canadians controlling this faceoff off to the near side. Play down there, Schroback able to dish away for a moment for the Americans. Canadians, though, regain possession back in their own half of the floor. Over to the far side, Canadians in front of their bench, now carried ahead by Laverne. Laverne with it now back for Grenepin. Grenepin looking back over again, down to the near side, and dish on down off the end board. This is Buck up with it to the far side. Tough angle shot, scores on it. Stokely looking at that one going, wow, how did that get in? I think it may have just barely caught off the inside of him there and gone in. We'll see the replay right here. And just had a little bit of space open on there.
You got to imagine the ball's coming about 70, 80 kilometers an hour. Stokely wasn't all the way over with his right shoulder and his right part of the body on the goal post. And you got to do that in every stretch of the imagination because that's a hard angle to shoot. But if you can get it in there, it's precision.
24 seconds, a time of that goal. It's an even strength goal for Canada. And I believe it's Kaisten from Laverne will get the official scoring on it here in a moment when they announce that the first shot of the period goes the way of the Canadians and the first goal of the period goes their way as well. Get a face-off at center now. We're going to get a violation, I believe, of the U.S. free hit off in place of the face-off. Vaha Vahe off to the far side. Controlled here by the Americans down toward the boards. It's going to be Kuston from Buck as the official scoring on that one. As the ball goes out of play, we're going to get a free hit far side for Team Canada. And they'll control from behind their own net. 45 seconds here into this opening. There's this final period of play as it's played down to the near side as we see Jetty getting his first play here for the Canadians. Play back to Berg, his shot through some traffic deflected wide and off the end boards. Back to the near side. Canada trying to look with it from there out to the near side corner. This is Friedley. Friedley on back down toward the corner. Played off the boards and way back out for Berg. His turning shot is blocked by Angerstig to the far side. Jetty up with it. He's battling with Moeller, a pair of defensemen listed there. Jetty getting a play up at forward here on this shift, and we get a whistle on an American free hit.
Yeah, the Canadians, you know, after that first goal, their energy has just exploded upwards, and their endorphins in their body are making them do different things, and they, the U.S. has got to control the court right now, control the ball, make sure they get their passes on.
Do you see the control for the Americans going off to the near side? Tapped ahead by Schrobeck. It'll go up and out of play. And we will get a free hit. I believe a Canadian free hit coming from the near side. So off of Schrobeck, as will be Grenepin now to take this one. Right at those near side boards. Minute and a half here into this final frame as it's Grenepin now to control back in his own end. Grenepin, far side. Dishes back off to Houston at the near side. Heard them say Houston there, so I've been pronouncing it wrong this whole night, but we'll try to get that corrected as best I can. As played on down toward the corner here, this is Buck. He had the assist on that last Canadian goal. Plays it off the boards. The Americans control it, though. It's played up the boards and out of play. And hit off of Buck. Buck grabbed his face there. Not sure if the ball hit off him there. I think that may have been it because no other calls or anything coming from this. Just an American free hit. We're a minute 45 into the period. Canadians with two shots on goal already and the one goal to make the 3-1 lead. As the Americans will control it off to the near side, it's Vaha Vahe dropping this one back for Fusi. Fusi back to Vaha Vahe. Sidesteps one, carries far side, now off to the boards in front of the American bench. Played on down toward the Canadian end at the far side corner. It's Berg up with it as he's met by his shoulder. Played to the near side, advantage paid as it'll be Canadians control ahead. Americans intercept. Fusi, far side. Look, he's got Aversold in front of him. Can't get it down to him, though, as he's met by two Canadians. And a hit from behind there by Jetty into the boards, and that should be a, I believe, an American power play upcoming here.
It will be. A little dirty play, but it's a little bit of the who's going to win the psychological battle here in the who's the toughest one, who's the most mentally toughest. Fauci's not a guy you take down. He's usually taking down people himself, but he got pushed off the boards. I think that was also a little payback.
Time of the penalty is the 2:11 mark of period number three. So the first penalty came at the 3:11 of the second. Now we've got the 2:11 mark of the third on this one. And we'll see an American power play, their second of the night.
It's very important that they move the ball fast here. They get it back and forth, try to take the Canadians off their stride and in the rhythm on the defense.
Vaha Vahe trying to play it down the boards. Tied up there, he'll regain possession though, back in his own end over to Fusi and the far side now for McVay. McVay looking, now turning, shooting, it's deflected wide down to the near side corner and out of play. USA ball though on the free hit.
Yeah, it is. I mean, they got to make a move and they got to try to get it in the net, and it's still early in the power play, so there it is.
Chance right there for Fusi is deflected wide off the netminder Goulet. Ball comes to the near side, play back over to Fusi again at the far side. Now it's now carrying it up toward center. Out to the far side now. Americans still controlled Hansen on down for McVay. McVay looking. He'll come to the near side. Back to the far side now. Turning as Hansen, not able to get the shot away as Grenepin got a piece of it. Vaha Vahe lost out there to Grenepin. He'll come back the other way shorthanded. Little contact there, no call. Turning and shooting is Smith. And he'll go up and out of play. Just hit a little too high on the blade there on his hit one time.
Now, Fusi put himself in a position where that the guy could get up underneath him. There was nothing dirty about that play at all.
Minute to go here on this man advantage as it's controlled at the far side by McVay. McVay across for Vaha Vahe. Keeping possession along the boards. He's being pestered heavily by Smith as the ball goes up and out of play once again. 1 minute to go on this man advantage for the Americans. 3:11 into this period, the third.
Canadians are doing a great job of frustrating the Americans. Mikko has had a tough time holding the ball in this power play.
Chance in front off a turnover and firing it just wide with Schrobeck, but excellent effort there, that forecheck there, forcing a turnover there by the Americans and generating a scoring chance at least.
Yeah, the Canadians, that was one of those basic things that you learn from the beginning is you never pass the ball in front of the net because somebody could be right there.
Schrobeck to the far side, the one-time attempt by McVay blocked. Off to the far side corner with Hansen now going after it. We get another whistle and a little more physical contact. There's there getting the body up on McVay there as they've been they've loved doing that here tonight.
It sure was, and I think they got away with number 77 playing on the floor.
It's Fusi from the near side for the Americans. On down, near side, Vaha Vahe has it tapped away. He'll come and get it off the near side boards. Back out for Fusi once again. Dario Fusi to the far side as it's be Hansen to carry down. Hansen one-handing it to McVay, back out to Fusi. Fusi far side turning, it's deflected. Chance in front there by Schrobeck, but couldn't get the shot away. Canada clears this one up and out of play. 17 seconds remaining here on this power play as Jetty is still sitting in the box on the boarding penalty.
Yep, they tried to... The Canadians are really tough on the box play here, and they're giving fits for the U.S. guys.
Back out toward the center, it's Moeller to the far side. Controlled there by Angerskig, he directs it down toward the near side corner, trying to get the shot away without much luck. Camda ties up, there's Kuston with this one. Kuston trying to look around, he'll come back toward the corner. Got a body all over him, we get a whistle here. And we're back to 5-on-5. So Canada, 2 of 2 on the penalty kill with a shorthanded goal here tonight. So excellent special teams start for them here in the series.
Yeah, they've done a great job on the box play here against the power play, and you got to give them credit. You know, they're more, a little bit more aggressive than the U.S. on this last box play.
Smith out to Grenepin, but we get a whistle, and referee tell him to settle it down a little bit here. It'll be an American free hit up coming off a holding call. As we are 4:32 into this third period, Canada on top of the Americans by a 3-1 score. From the far side, Americans control is played on ahead. Here by, I believe that is Moeller, sending it on down. Quick chance there by Abersold, but it'll go wide and down to the near side. Canada with possession, as it's going to be carried on ahead by Lowry Berg. Berg looking, Blanco bothering him, as it's sent on ahead for Walsh and off on the far side. Now for, I believe that's Lacaire getting his first time out on the floor here tonight. Diving attempt there is knocking away with Stokely. Americans regain possession now with Abersold up the far side on for Moeller. Moeller trying to force his way through, can't do it, he'll have to drop back for Colin Kenai Abersold. Abersold with it at the far side, now directing it towards center, over the near side for Blanco, back into the American zone for Fusi. Over to the far side now, Americans controlling with Moeller, back for Fusi one more time at the far side. Fusi drawing it back, he'll spin away from one and carry to the far side, on up the boards, brought ahead. Chance there, broken away though, and the Canadians will intercept the control. Lowry Berg at the near side, sending it up the boards, carried on here by Walsh, that's Tristan Walsh sending it on down. Walsh with him, putting the brakes on as he runs right into Blanco, who comes away with the ball. Blanco now back over to the far side and controlled here by Moeller, and the Americans will get a partial change on here, and now Moeller will join them for a full change of 5. At least I thought he was going to, he's still out there. Now as he controls and plays ahead for Schrobeck. Back to Moeller one more time, down the far side boards. Americans control with Schrobeck, far side corner, trying to make his way across, but hasn't broken up and out of play. American free hit to come at the far side.
The balls aren't really bouncing from the U.S. right now. They were really lucky in that ball. I thought it was a Canadian ball, actually.
Schrobeck at the far side, trying to play it back towards center. Americans maintain possession for a moment. Now it's a 3-on-1 chance for the Americans to break it up, and Schrobeck cuts it with a very high stick. And so with that, we get the you-can't-do-that call from a Canadian fans up here. So we're going to see a power play upcoming here for Canada.
That was just so unnecessary. Schrobeck, he knows it too. He shouldn't have gone after the ball. He should have just let it kept going. And that's going to put the U.S. in a tough situation defensively right now. Canadians are really good at the power play and really effective. So we'll, the U.S. really has to get down low and play great defense across the board.
Ball coming down at just outside center here as will be controlled by the Canadians just inside their own zone off to the far side. Canadians control, near side, now it's Grenepin. Grenepin looking down toward the corner, controlled there by Smith, back out to Grenepin. Grenepin looking, he'll turn, play back down to Smith at the corner. Smith looking from a tough angle, tries to play back for Grenepin. Grenepin turning and shooting, it's blocked, picked up by Berg. Lowry Berg at the far side, settles this one down on his stick. Play it back down toward the corner. Ball hit off of, I believe, may have hit off the referee there, but was heading out of play. They're gonna give him a face off now instead at the far, the near side down the corner.
If you look at the center play with both Fusi and their middle guy in front of the goal, and there's a really tough fight going on there. It's something good to see because they're playing clean but tough ball.
So it actually turned into a U.S. free hit as it's played back down to the Canadian end. U.S. will just take the free clear off of that. Play back to the near side for Grenepin. He'll play it on down to the corner. Smith looking, trying to play back to Grenepin. He'll have to regain possession now as he's got all over him. Play back to the near side, Smith walking in, has it knocked away. Americans try to clear, but can't quite get it all the way down. Berg holding at center. He'll look from the near side now, turning and shooting, blocked in front, may have hit off his own guy, as he's deflected up and out of play. Berg trying to pick a corner up there, but ends up bouncing it right off of Tristan Walsh, there, right off his shoulder.
That's great defensive play this far. They're keeping their angles, and they're keeping their selves in front of the hot spots in the net, so hand it to the U.S. so far.
Berg plays to the far side where it's going to be held by Lumiola. Back out to Berg at the near side. Back over far side again for Lumiola. He'll turn, he'll shoot, it's blocked. Chance back the other way. Vaha Vahe, though, had the ball bounce on him a little bit. Canada will keep it in. Down to the far side, now it's Smith one more time. Going up against Vaha Vahe, sidesteps one, walking to the front, broken up nicely by a couple players. Blanco getting the last piece of it there, and he'll carry it out for the Americans at the far side. Two-on-two shorthanded, but picked away. It'll be the Canadians controlling. Down to 30 to go here on this man advantage for the Canadians. From the near side, this is going to be Berg controlling it for Team Canada. Berg from the near side, just inside the center line. Looking, he'll go far side. Controlled there by Lumiela and down to the corner. Chance here is brought around behind the net. I believe that might be Walsh who comes out near side. That was indeed Walsh as his shot is deflected up and out of play. Canada with the free hit out of the corner. 13 seconds on the man advantage here as Canada will take the free hit out to Berg at the near side point. Final 10 seconds of their man advantage. Cross to the far side. Walking in is Buck. His chance goes through everybody. Another try right there from Grenepin, who goes wide off the end boards. Out to the near side, Tristan Walsh has it poked away. Off the near side boards, and they are back to 5-on-5. U.S. 1-of-1 here on the penalty kill. Excellent work right there back in their own zone.
Well, they needed that for their confidence defensively, and they matched up pretty good on the front, and they used their energy well. They had they changed it out there so they could get more players with fresh legs.
About 6.5 to go here in regulation. Canada with a 3-1 advantage thus far as it's controlled far side by the defenseman Laverne. He will tap it back for his defensive partner Jonathan Houston. Houston now looking on ahead. He'll carry off to the far side. Houston back to the near side as it's controlled here by Laverne, sent down off the end boards. Buck up with it here for the Canadians, trying to play it back toward his centerman. I believe that was Grenepin at the near side. Buck now back to Grenepin again. Grenepin to the far side. Controlled from there, looking, turning through traffic. Ball bounces to the near side corner. Play back out again for Grenepin. Plays the far side now for Houston one more time. He'll settle it and play it on down to the corner as this is Laverne with it. He's met there by Moeller. Ball goes up and out of play. Should be a Canada free hit, I believe. Yes, it will be a Canadian free hit.
Yes, it will be.
Excellent defense there, though, by Moeller, able to get the body right there in on him and keep him from getting out of that corner at the very least.
Exactly, and then the U.S. needs to do that, but they need to get the ball back up the court and get something going. And we have a Canadian goalie that is almost sleeping over here because he's got nothing to do.
One shot on goal so far for the Americans in this period as the ball is played down to the near side and back out. Goulet finally wakes up there and he comes out to play the ball over to the near side.
Got a little action.
Yeah. As this is going to be Berg now to carry it in front of his own net. Blanco watching him very closely, forcing it to the far side. Pass ahead, broken up. Chance here for the Americans if they hurry. 3-on-3. You get a whistle, and I believe a free hit coming for the Americans. He's either sold not too happy with the contact they had to face there.
The Canadians are so quick to, if they lose the ball, is fight for the ball back.
Lumiela just took something up high there, trying to snap his head back, and they do indeed get the free hit, but no penalty at least off of it there. A little bit of embellishment there. I saw his head really just snap around right there, but he got him to call at least.
I think that was good enough for the goose and good enough for the gander kind of a thing. I think the referee made two weak calls on that, that for both the teams.
Play back the other way. We've got a loose stick on the floor as the Americans score with the ball as it's Ebersold far side in front of the Canadian bench. We get a whistle here and Ebersold quickly back to the bench. I believe we've got both teams can make a quick change on here. I think it's going to be an American free hit the way they're lining up here.
Yeah, it is.
From the far side, it is Fusey out there for the Americans, and he will take it and send it on back for McVay. McVay from center sends it ahead for Schrobeck. Can't quite make his way through the traffic. Directly to the near side, though, as McVay is able to come up with it again for the Americans. McVay will spin move there, trying to get his way to the front. Forces it around behind the net. Chance there. Schrobeck still trying to battle for the loose ball. Trickles through the crease and goes back to the end boards. Send round over to the near side. Canadians try to clear this one out. Unable to do so as the Americans keep it up, but we'll get a whistle and a free hit for Canada as Houston and McVay once again coming together down there getting tangled up.
Yeah, they've got a fight going on. They've made their own little grudge match with each other, and you don't know. The U.S. Paid off. They got the ball back.
Vaha Vahe to play to the far side, directed on down by Ebersold. Canadians maintain possession, though, at the corner, and they'll take it around behind their own net. This is brought out to the far side, courtesy of the defenseman Laverne. Laverne now deals with a shoulder right there from the American player, but able to shrug it away and keep possession at the same time. Excellent effort there by the defenseman. Pass across, broken up, goes off an American stick and out, so Canadian free hit upcoming. 10:35 into this period.
We've got 5 more minutes to go, and both teams, everything is on the line for them. They know it, and they need to keep the intensity up all the way through the end of the game here.
Canadians controlled off their free hit as Berg sends this one the length of the floor and down off the end boards from the near side corner. Going after this one, it is the forward Stephen Friedley, who we've been mentioning a lot here tonight for Canada. Play back out toward the point intended for Berg. Friedley's going to come back with possession as he one hands it down behind the net. Going to get down to Bill Petrie. Petrie to the far side, turning and shooting at goes wide from Walsh. Loose ball bouncing around to the near side. The Canadians up with it. Played back down to Canadian zone. It will be Etu Lumiola controlling it here for the Canadians. Off to Lowry Berg at the near side. Blanco pestering him as he'll carry now back behind the net. It's Blanco and Abersold as your forechecking forwards here for the Americans. They'll now back off, and Canada will lead their charge out of their zone. From the near side, Grenepin sends it on down toward the American end of the floor. Americans up with it, though, it's quickly intercepted. They'll control it at the far side of Fusen, losing his footing there for a moment, and losing possession of the ball as well. Put toward the front, nothing doing there. Americans try to scoop it up and get it out, and finally will do so with Strobeck to carry it back now around behind his own net. Off the near side, Strobeck off the boards and down, controlled at the near side. I believe this is McVay with it. McVay dishes it off for Strobeck at the corner. He's going to go up and out of play.
Boy, the bounces are sure not going the way of the U.S. right now. The Canadians are picking up 3 out of 4 balls that go out of bounds, and there's a reason for that. The more aggressive team usually is the one that gets the ball back.
Another collision there involving McVay as the Americans will control it off a free hit to the far side. It's Moeller. Moeller with this one as he holds and sends it on ahead and off the stick and out of play. They're off of Hansen trying to tap it back and just lost control of it.
It's called club control. You got to be able to use your blade and have control of even the toughest passes, and we're not getting the control on that. We need
under 3 minutes to play. Here's the Canadians control back in their own zone. Lumiola at the far side. Lumiola looking back off near side as will be carried on by Friedley and sent down. Friedley turning, shooting just wide of that far side post. Ball bounced to the far side corner. It's Moeller up with it, trying to clear it for the Americans. Unable to do so. Second effort does so, but now we get the whistle. And I believe it is going to be, it will be a slashing call here against the Americans. Moeller's going to sit for 2 minutes.
That was definitely an unnecessary thing for the U.S. They don't need that with 2.5 minutes left in the period. Moeller goes out, and now it's going to, you got two minutes left of power play, and they're going to have only 40 seconds left to play 5-on-5. So they have to stop them now. They got to do everything they can to stop them and make sure that they hold the score down and go into tomorrow night.
Well, we did see Canada score a shorthanded goal earlier in the second period here tonight, so anything can happen, obviously, here. 3-1 game, and that would be huge for the Americans. I mean, if you can get back to a one-goal deficit there, you're at least giving yourself a chance there. You may be able to get Stokely out, get an extra attacker on there for those final 40 seconds if you're able to capitalize.
You're right about that. I mean, it's very demoralizing to get the a goal against you on the box play. I think the Canadians are going to play very, very tame here. They're not going to be very aggressive forward. They're going to hold the ball as long as they can. They know they got a 2-point lead, so they're going to try to keep it to themselves and have a high possession of percentage of the next 2.5 minutes in the game.
2:39 remaining on the clock here in this period. Excuse me. This is a 3-1 lead for the Canadians, and they will have a 2-minute man advantage. A free hit upcoming here at the far side, down in the American offensive, or down in the Canadian offensive zone here, the American defensive side of the floor. It is Lumiola to take it with Berg. Lumiola looking, plays it back out to Berg. Berg just inside the center line. Being pestered there by McVay. He's got to circle away and come to the near side for Grenepin. Grenepin down the boards for Berg. He'll go across to the far side. Controlled from there, this is Lumiola. Lumiola looking from that far side in front of the scorer's table. He'll go back near side for Berg. Berg now carries it over the line, sending it on down toward the near side. It's going to go off the Canadian player and out. Americans here with a free hit. Only 20 seconds killed off on that. Canadians will control it, though, as it'll be at the far side with Lumiola. And he'll go to Grenepin at the near side. Grenepin looking, sending it on down toward the corner. Canadians control there, back out to Grenepin once again. Grenepin back in his own half of the floor. He'll go over to Berg. Berg now skating it on, or carrying it on over.
Looked like he was skating.
Old habits are hard to break on some of this stuff. He's played to the near side. Now Grenepin has his shot attempt blocked. Comes down, another block in front. Another chance right there, rolling off the stick, though, of, I believe that was Smith. It'll be the Americans able to clear it down. It is Shovik carry. Picked up by the Canadians, they'll quickly go in transition back the other way. A minute to go here on this penalty kill for the Americans, as Berg will carry it slowly ahead. Berg looking, he'll go off far side. Controlled there, back out to Berg again. His shot deflates off a body in front. Petrie with a try, puts it up and out of play. 50 seconds remaining here on this penalty kill here for the Americans.
That was interesting. That was quite a high stick on that one, and the ball went flying out of there, and there was nobody throwing him out of the game, and that could have been very pivotal if they called that.
They get the free hit out of the corner. The Americans send it down the length of the floor. McVay in to give chase to it, but it's going to be the Canadians controlling the Berg, sending it to the far side for Lumiela. Lumiela back over to Berg at the near side. Down to a minute and 20 seconds to play here in regulation. Minute 15, actually, now as it's Berg to carry this one ahead. Berg now on down toward the corner. Played back behind the net. This is going to be brought around by Friedley. Far side out to Lumiela to Berg. Berg looking. Takes it to the far side, putting on the brakes. Now turning it, shooting. It's blocked in front. Americans back the other way here. The mids go here in regulation. 15 to go on this penalty kill for the Americans. Angerstig at the near side. He gets shouldered up high. No call there. It's going to be now Grenepin to carry in ahead. Grenepin trying to go high and puts it well up and out of play. 10 seconds left on the penalty kill. 49 seconds left to play here in regulation.
The U.S. has done a great job to defend this power play. There's been a lot of near misses, but the U.S. has hung in there, and now they're giving themselves a shot to get back in this game. They got only 45 seconds left.
Play back to the far side now. This is going to be played up the boards and out of play. 2 seconds remaining as Mueller getting ready to come out of the box there. He'll have to just have a seat here once again for at least a couple more seconds. 14:19 the time on the clock there, so 41 seconds left in regulation. Canada still on top by their 3-1 score. The Lumiela even strength goal, the goal of record so far in this one. Played off to the near side. We're back to 5-on-5 play as Mueller will return. He'll head straight to the bench. Getting extra forward here. Three forwards, two defensemen out there for the Americans, and they give up a late goal. Oh, man. And that's a backbreaker right there. I mean, they did such a great job on the penalty kill and just walking in there and just barely, I mean, it was off the post and in, it looked like there from just inside the line.
That's something they just did not need, and that's, a, like you said, a backbreaker for the U.S. team. They got 30 seconds left. They should have been very aware of, but the somebody dropped the ball there defensively and let the ball fly by. The ball's going that slow. The goalie should have had it to taken that as well, but those things happen in these kind of games, and the U.S. putting themselves in a tougher position for tomorrow night.
Yep. So 14:30, the time of the goal. I believe it was Houston on the shot there. I don't believe it was deflected in front or anything. Not sure if we will insist on it, but we'll keep an ear out for that here in a moment when they announce it. But we've got 11 shots on goal for the Canadians, it says, according to the scoreboard here, 9 for the Americans. So only one shot on goal for the Americans this period. So Canada's an excellent job. I mean, shutting everything down here in this period, taking that lead and protecting it very well back in their own end. Controlled at the near side. They do need to give Tristan Walsh the assist. As played from the near side, turning and shooting, it's deflected wide, far side corner. The final 10 seconds tick down here in tonight's game. Brought back around behind that is Lumiela off to the near side. Tristan Walsh with it, he turns and shoots, it's blocked to the far side, and that will do it for this one tonight. 4-1, your final score. Team Canada on top in game number one of this two-game series.
The most pivotal game changer in this whole thing was the first 24 seconds when they put their ball right in the goal, and that just kind of just changed the whole perspective of the game. The U.S. couldn't get themselves emotionally back into the game, and this is what happens.
Get a quick replay right here on, I believe that's the, yeah, this is the first goal of the period, that one that came 24 seconds into, you just mentioned. Just such a tough angle right there to come in on, and just, yeah, Netminder Stokely's not quite able to get to that post. Right here, you get the blast in the 4-1 game.
Yeah, Stokely had a tough time seeing these things that are going on there. They're doing a good job, the Canadians, of putting up a wall in front of them, and Stokely just couldn't get to the ball at all.
Right there's that hit that you saw earlier, gave the U.S. their second power play, and a couple other highlights I'll show you here from this one. As we get the presentations down at floor level here, we'll go to those here in just a moment and see if we can get the, I believe they have some awards they hand out here at the end of the game here as Stokely goes down the line there, giving his teammates the high fives on his way to collect, I believe, player of the game, I would believe, for the Team USA on this one, potentially.
And for Team Canada, number 67,
Ike Lumiela. So the Ike Lumiela getting the award for Team Canada here.
Yeah, and well deserved too. He was very stable in the whole game, in all aspects of the game, his passing, his shooting, his ability to play defense and frustrate the heck out of the U.S. players.
Now, Lumiela had the goal that he can't do nothing.
Two teams tomorrow night, 7 o'clock for the second round of this World Football Championship qualifying match.
And so as you hear there, as like you said, same teams, same place, same time. Tomorrow night, they'll go at it again. Game two of this one What's the biggest thing that the Americans are going to have to turn around here to do there tomorrow night?
Well, I think they should lift their confidence level up and not be afraid to go down the court with the ball spread it out, get the ball moving back and forth. A lot of one-touch passes instead of carrying the ball down two, three, four, five touches apiece and playing floor ball like it should be played.
All right, we're about done here for tonight. Once again, a big thank you to all of you for tuning in here. Hopefully we'll see you again tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Central Time start once again for this game between the Canadians and the Americans. Big thanks to our Go Live Sportscast crew for handling all of the video and audio mixing for us here tonight. Theo, thanks for joining me here. I hope we'll see you tomorrow night as well.
It's been a great pleasure. Thanks a lot for having me on.